I was born into a poor peasant family, but a little bit better than most. And I studied in the public school system that were managed by American teachers brought here on SS Thomas, and they were called Thomasites. So practically, my elementary and high school life in school was molded by the American public school system led by American teachers. And from them, I learned so much about the American history of revolution against the British Empire. And I learned to admire and even love your heroes, like Washington for his courage and honesty, your Jefferson for his libertarian ideas, and others like Thomas Paine, Patrick Henry, but most of all, I admired and adored your Abraham Lincoln, whose ideas of democracy and freedom and his simplicity of life. I practically read all the books written about him since his childhood and up to lately now by Sandberg. So I continue to be a faithful lover of America, the real America and its history. But that pushed me into my self-conscious obligations as a Filipino. So I have to learn also about my country's history, and I learned to admire and love our history of struggle against Spanish domination. And we produced our number one Philippine hero, Dr. Jose Rizal. And next to him was our proletarian leader, a simple, ordinary worker, Andres Bonifacio. And later we produced another leader, a lawyer, Apolinario Mabini. So my heroes became to be my native heroes. The triumvirate of leadership, Mabini, the parliamentarian, Bonifacio, the action man and revolutionary, and Rizal, the idealist who guided us with his ideas to the present day. I remember very clearly until now my American school teachers, and I call them, maybe these people represent the American people in general. They were so kind and thoughtful and helpful. They discipline us in the right way, and we obeyed. So even young in age, I appreciated American public education system they introduced into the Philippines. So I call myself a product of the American public school system under those American teachers. They were very meticulously thoughtful of us, and no touch of aristocracy compared to our Filipino teachers or our Filipino landlords and public officials. Those American teachers really made me love them in my memory as real good Americans. There is a mixture of paternalism, or shall I call it love with discipline, deeply concerned, sincerely concerned about our upbringing. But of course, the emphasis was on the honesty of Washington, on the libertarian ideas of Jefferson and Patrick Henry, and the simplicity, humbleness, but firmness in the right of Lincoln. His Gettysburg Address, in fact, was one of our favorite recitations when we are told to compete for recitation in school. So I memorized both. Our last farewell of our national hero, it is a famous poem, not only here in the Philippines, but around the world, and the Gettysburg Address. And the most important element or portion of Gettysburg Address, I remember, was a government of the people, by the people, and for the people shall not perish from this earth. So I immediately concluded, the Philippines is a part of that, from this world of Lincoln, that all the world, all humanity must enjoy democracy. That's another incentive for me to read further, and I memorize your Declaration of Independence, that we hold these things to be self-evident, that all men were created equal, that they were endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, and among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. My gosh, I said, we must have this in the Philippines, because the way our government was run was still the remnant of Spanish colonialism, and then, during my days, the landlords were still in power. What happened with these Americans who said they will help us to be free? They have sanctioned, cuddled, preserved into office these landlords and these feudal landlords and selfish people who were also serving the Spaniards during their time. So that was the quandary I was in.